So I think the healthy birthing practices, which were practiced with my wife as well, they go a very long way. First thing is the comfort while you deliver is much more when you walk around. Your contractions, the way you handle your contractions is much better. You're not bound down. You don't have to lie down. Eating is very important. So there is a theory that people use enemas. At least back in the day, they used to use enemas to clear the gut, so that while the baby is pushed out, you don't have anything in your rectum. But eating really helped, because the last gasp when she was out of energy, and those bars of chocolate were very important. So that practice is extremely important. The fact that eating helped her deliver. Position of delivering is, I cannot say how important that is. The fact that she could push the baby out in 3 hours, it's all because of the position. Be it a squat, or be it on fours, or be it in water. So these things were already practiced prior to her going into labor, and she could actually choose which position she was most comfortable at pushing. Skin to skin, like I already mentioned, has taken the mother-child bond to a different level, and it's cemented now that he knows that she's the mom, and he knows how safe he is with her. So I think these practices being practiced and having published literature supporting it, I think these things are very important. And the fact that these are being practiced at Birth Village gives me a lot of comfort that, we practice every single one of these things, and it's showing how well, we are recovering. With respect to, did I have any striking moments, or did I have any events which actually taught me how natural birthing happens? I would actually say no. And the no is a good no, because everything was very clearly explained. It was orchestrated. We knew what to expect. So once we knew what to expect, there were no surprises. And in medical care, I think predictability is very important. If a procedure or a process is predictable, then it's great. You know how it's gonna pan out. So it was very predictable, because everything, every step, how she would feel, how long she would feel the pain, how long we should wait, when should we come in, what is that point where she will tell us that we have to come in, and then we have to come in then. Nitty-gritties, attention to detail was fantastic. So everything was laid out in front of us. So we would only do what we were told to. I would just follow instructions. Even between her contractions, what she was supposed to do when the next contraction comes. It was completely clearly explained. She would be in position waiting for a contraction. So because of these things, the contractions were very effective, pushing, helping the baby come out. The fetal heart rate was monitored continuously. Between every set of contractions, her fetal heart rate was monitored. The fetal heart rate was monitored, which was very warm, which was very heartening to know, because the baby was doing absolutely fine. There was no sign of distress. So I think there was no surprises, and I'm very happy that there were no surprises. It's a pleasant sur you know, it's a pleasant feeling that there were no surprises. Everything went according to plan. It was like a folded paper. You would just keep opening it, and at the end of it, we had a baby.